I think it's pretty much the same things. Just kind of playing fast, playing a little faster. Spacing is still the same, it being emphasized, and I think it's just more energy and more free flowing and just kind of more getting to your game and not really overthinking. It's just kind of straightforward and playing fast and having fun with it. And if you shoot a bad shot, just keep shooting and just on to the next play. But we try definitely playing a little faster and definitely getting the, pushing the pace and moving the ball a lot.
All right, Eddie Sefko, the next one.
Yeah, I'm having to go rewatch in the daytime because it's a little late sometimes. But, I mean, man, it's incredible. You talk about Final Four, top four semifinals of the Olympics. That's tough. It's like something that you can't really make up. And him leading the team and doing the same thing here with the Mavericks, I think it's going to carry over very much so. So I think that is just incredible. And then Josh Green with Australia, that's an incredible experience I know for him. Being over there and just taking it all in, and just you're in the Olympics, like that's just very, very like a life dream, a goal. So I'm glad for those guys and supporting those guys, and hopefully they meet up, or hopefully they just continue to keep going, and whoever brings the gold home, brings the gold. Repeat the question, I'm sorry.
I was just wondering, what's it like for you going through the summer league process, being going together on this team, some guys you haven't played with before, and then how would you define success during this period of time?
What's really crazy is a lot of those guys I really already know from previous years of playing AAU or having known them through somebody else that I played AAU with or even in college. A lot of those guys are we've known each other over the years, whether personal or just seen it for guys. So it's we're real. Everybody's real close, and everybody's real together. And for me, this is my first time going through this process. So I'm not technically a rookie, but I feel like I'm a red shirt in some ways because last year I didn't have a summer league, and this time I'm actually going through the process of having to go through what a summer league is like and being in that environment. And now I guess, being this my kind of my second year in the being a professional, and then first year in this is definitely my maturity is definitely being shown, and I'm using what I learned from last year and watching and seeing those guys in practice and seeing those guys that we played against in the NBA and utilizing that in the practices now and helping me to get better. So it's definitely a great experience so far. And for me, for success, I just want to go out there and compete. I worked my tail off this whole summer. Everybody in the building and the organization can vouch for that. But now it's just time for me to go out there and just have fun and just go do what I've been working on. And I'll take that next step in my professional career and show that I've gotten better since the last time they see me, which was, a little spurs in here last year, but in college. And just I'm excited for it and not putting too much pressure on it. Just excited to play in this organization. I'm thankful for everybody and just kind of going out there to playing for those that believe in me.
Okay, Dorothy.
Hi, Nate. Thank you for your time on today. Along those same lines, when you think back to a year ago, where you were personally and professionally, can you kind of share what this opportunity for this summer league means to you from a personal standpoint to include yourself? And then,
Well, a year ago, I don't even, if you would have just described me a year ago, I wouldn't necessarily know who I was compared to now. I've grown so much as a young man and on the court and off the court, so much from last month to this month, I've grown so much. So I'm always growing and growing and growing and being put in situations where I'm having to grow, depend on my faith more, depend on my family more, and depend on just doing what I do and what got me here and keeping that same hunger and just being who I am and not trying to get caught up in, oh, I'm in the NBA, but being thankful, being more appreciative and having more gratitude. And on the court, just being around the environment. Before I never really had anybody to say, oh, call somebody like, hey, you know, in college and high school that was in the NBA to lean on if I need some advice or anything. So now me being around it, talking to guys, talking to DA, talking to Sham, talking to the vets. You know, I was texting Tim yesterday about, you know, about some things on the court, and he just was in contact, and we've been in contact, you know, all throughout the summer, just calling him, just asking him questions about being a professional and the other guys being around. So me being in this environment and just being in the door is just really helped in my development, because, you know, knowing is half the battle. So if you don't know and you just kind of on the outside looking in, then you'll think it's one way, but then you'll have a culture shock when you actually get in here. So that's that on the development. And being a gym rat, you know, I'm just here early, stay all day. I don't have anything else to do. I'm out here by myself, so I don't have any other responsibilities. So I wanted to get better. This is what I want. And me seeing it last year, and me wanting to take that next development and that next step in my whole career and my life, I'm just in the gym all day, every day, working on my game, body. Working on my body, working on my handle, and working on my shot and things like that, and not trying to prove anybody wrong, but just trying to get better. Stack my days and get better, 1% better every single day, not trying to worry about trying to prove anybody wrong.
All right, and Chuck Cooperstein.
Hey, Nate, back to Luka for a second. Just in watching him in this atmosphere, is there anything different that you see about him playing with those guys versus how he plays with you, and how he interacts with those guys versus how he interacts with you? And the taking this experience and carrying over to when you guys get back together in late September, do you see the growth potential from that?
When you say those guys, what do you mean? Oh, okay.
It's almost like he's taking on a coaching role, kind of an on the floor coaching role with them, as opposed to maybe how he has to play with the guys.
I think he's really just he kind of now he's for Slovenia. I would say, you know, like you said, he's taking a more coaching role. But I mean, here he leads by example in the same way, and he's still doing the same thing. He may not be as visual with it here. But, I mean, he's still the leadership. He's still being a leader and leading the team to the same height. So I don't think it's a difference. I mean, obviously, it's his country, so he has a lot more pride in it. But, I don't know how to speak too much on that.
All